Hello everybody, today we will be having a look at how to implement character movement in Unity. Let's get straight to it! So, first up, the two art assets for this tutorial are both free and the links can naturally be found in the description below. Alright, first we want to create a world, which does not have to be fancy, it just has to be a platform to walk on. Let's see, 4 tiles. No, that's not quite enough. Let's do 6 instead. Each box needs a 2D collider for simplicity, so let's add those. This is so that the physics engine can interact with these tiles. Next up, we need a character. Which one shall we pick? Let's see. This one seems cute. Let's use this one. Then we'll want to add a 2D box collider to this as well. And make sure that the bounds are just about right. For the sake of this tutorial, it does not have to be perfect. Yep, that'll do just fine. And finally, we want to add a 2D rigid body. This is so that we can jump around later. We do not need to edit any settings here. That's all we need on the Unity side. Let's dive into the script by creating a new one. Let's call it Character 2D Controller and open it. As always, let's take 2 seconds to clean up the default script. For the x-axis, we want to make use of the default horizontal input axis, which returns 1 for the right arrow key and -1 for the left arrow key. All we want to do is create a new vector 3 with the x-axis set to our input value, and multiply that by time.delta time to smoothen out movement over the frames. Then finally, we want to multiply that by a float variable called movement speed. This is so that we can adjust the movement speed from the editor. With this done, we should be able to move around. That's a little slow. That's much better. Now let's set up jumping. Since we will want to use the rigid body multiple times, let's grab a reference to it when the character is created. As with the movement, let's use the default input system, but this time using jump as a get button down. On the rigid body, all you need to do is add a force in the y-axis. So let's create a variable called jump force. This will also be a float. It's important to note that the force we want to apply is an impulse. We can check the y-axis velocity to only allow a single jump. That should be it for jumping. Fantastic, that works well. However, I'd like to jump higher. Perfect. And that's it. In less than 5 minutes, you now know how to implement 2D character movement in Unity. Head over to Patreon to see how you can request new tutorials like this, or simply to see what's in the making. Also, don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and notification buttons to stay up to date with our beginner in 5 minutes series or our intermediate in 15 minutes series. And that's a wrap. See you in the next one.